Are you able to fix the issue other day that we are facing some issue in filter side? So my intention is I want to create one filter. That filter should work for particular URL, particular endpoint URL. That is my intention. For that, I created one filter, handle print filter, implements filter. Screen share now.
Yes, it is now.
The intention of this filter is I want to execute this filter only intercept the particular URL. Whenever client uses a particular URL, that time only I want to execute this filter. Okay. For that particular customization, we need to register this filter in the config file. I created a configuration file called filter config. Inside the filter config files, I am injecting filter registration bin using admin address. The filter config is a filter configuration file. Using this config file, I am registering my handle printer filter. I am using one API called filter registration bin. Using that particular class, I am registering my filter in Spring Boot application. Register bin set filter of my filter, handle print filter. Then register bin dot add URL pattern. I am saying that whenever any rest point comes with this URL, only invoke this filter. Only invoke this filter, I am saying. Okay, instead of do filter, I am printing this. That's it. The filter is executing. Nothing else. Okay. Previously, I was giving here only the print. So it's not working. Expecting to print all the path. Print up to this path. See, whatever endpoint coming with after print, those endpoint will execute. Whatever endpoint executing that comes with print, in such a case, our filter get execute. Okay. I'll start the application. What is a controller method? Controller method is a print. I'll go to execute this API customer slash print. So the filter is executed. Now it's print. Now it's a printing. So the purpose of filter is whenever before processing request, the purpose of filter is before processing request, before sending a response to the client, if you want to do some activity, if you want to intercept the requested response object, in such a case, we can go with filter. Good example is authorization. Whenever you do authorization, we can use filter object. You can use a filter. If you user send sending a request to invoke a particular endpoint, using filters, we can intercept that request. We can check the particular user is valid or not. If it is valid, we can allow to further processing. Otherwise, we can throw the error. Okay, in such a case, we can use the filters. Okay, we're going to see that example part of Spring Security. Okay, now next we're going to talk about interceptors. Filters versus interceptor. What is filters? What is interceptor? You know about the filter now. What is the filter? When we can go to use the filters. The filters, we have three callback method. Do filter, edit and destroy. Filters and interceptors are closely same. So both are mostly same only. Okay. We can intercept the request and response. In both filters and interceptor, we can intercept the request and response. That is the purpose of filters and interceptor. There are some few difference. Okay. The filters, we have a three method: do filter, edit and destroy. Do filter execute each and every time. Do filter execute each and every time. Correct. Whenever send a request, the do filter callback method get executed. These are callback method. These methods we call it as a callback method. What do you mean meaning of callback method? Callback method, it will called by system. Called by system. We are not calling. If you do some activities, that method get executed. That is called as a callback method. Filter is having a three callback method: do filter, edit, and destroy. do filter execute each and every time when I perform a request. Init method execute only once. Whenever you start the application, that time init method execute. Destroy method execute only once. Whenever you stop the application, that time destroy method get executed. Okay. Then what is the interceptor? Interceptor also, we can intercept request and response. Before processing a request, before processing a response, we can intercept. We can intercept intercept those object using interceptor. But in the case of interceptor, we have a three different callback method. Pre-handle, post-handle, after completion. We have a three callback method. Pre-handle, post-handle, after completion. If your application using interceptor, it will behave like this. Whenever send a request, before request going into the controller, that is our controller class. Before request going to the controller, before processing a request, this pre-handle execute. Then post-handle. Once client send a request, request processed and the response also generated in the controller side. In such a case, in that time, the post-handle execute. Then after completion. If a client has sent a request, request processed, response generated in a server side. That is your controller method return response. This is a controller method. Whenever client send a request, before executing this method, pre-handle execute. Then once process this request, post-handle execute. Now this method execution is completed. Response sent to the client. Using that response, client generated their view. That time after completion execute. Three different cases. Three method execute in the interceptor. We have a three callback method: pre-handle, post-handle, after completion. Pre-handle before executing the controller, before processing the request. Post-handle after processing the request, after generating a response. Post-handle after completion, response sent back to the client. Using that response, client generated their view. That time after completion execute. So we have a three cases in the case of interceptor. So here filters, interceptor, in both the case we are dealing with a request and response. Then what is the major difference? In the case of filters, we can deal with only request and response. In the case of interceptor, we can deal with request, response. Also, you can take the meta information of your controller class. For example, what is the meta information? This is a controller class, right? Whenever send a request, I can take what is the controller class name, what is the method name, what is the parameter. This meta information we can take in the case of interceptor. I want to log this information in my log file. In such a case, we can use interceptor. We can log your handler. This class called as a handler class. In the case of interceptor terminology, we will call it as a handler class. Whenever send a request, one controller class get executed. That controller class, we can call it as a handler class. We can take that handler class meta name, meta information using interceptor. Okay, that is the one purpose. That is the one difference when compared to filters. Then we can interact with model object. In the case of filters, we can interact with only request and response. I want to interact with the model object. What is the model object here? Customer, right? This is the customer object, is a model object. I want to modify this model object. That is possible in the case of interceptor. That is a major difference. Okay. Now I'm going to see one example here. I'll go to comment out this line first. I'll make it only SOP. Okay. If you want to create an interceptor, we need to create one class. That class must implement that with handle interceptor. That class implement with handle interceptor, interceptor interface. Then we need to override three methods: pre-handle, post-handle, after completion. Pre-handle, post-handle, after completion. Okay. This pre-handle invoke whenever sender request. Before processing the request, the pre-handle invoke. Then this method return true or false. We can return either true or false. I will tell later what is the use of this. Pre-handle return either true or false. Here I am returning true. After processing a request, after generating a response in the server side, post handle get invoked. This post handle get invoked. After the response, after sending a response to the client, then after completion get invoked. Okay. Now we are going to see this print statement is printing or not. The three print statement should print. Okay, this is the way of creating an interceptor. After creating interceptor, we need to register. We need to register this interceptor in our Spring Boot. In our application, we need to register. Okay. For that, we need to create one configuration file. Here I created one configuration file called interceptor config. That configurator class must implement with WebMEC configurer. WebMEC configurer. Okay. Since this is a configuration file, I am using that configuration annotation. Then I am auto-wiring my interceptor class. Auto-wired API logger interceptor, API logger interceptor. Then I am overriding one method called add interceptor. This method coming from WebMEC configurer. I am overriding this method. In this method accepting one parameter called interceptor registry. Using this object, I am adding my interceptor in Spring Boot app. This is called you are registering this interceptor. Once you register, this interceptor start work. Okay. I'll start the application now. Server started now. Now I want to invoke some endpoint. The customer controller, I have one endpoint. I think I don't have to explain this. We have seen this example several times. I am adding a customer. I am adding the customer to my array list. Okay. What is the request here? Okay. I sent a request. We'll look at here pre-handle callback method, post-handle after completion. So this endpoint, this statement printed, this statement printed, this statement printed. Three methods are get executed whenever send a request. Now we're going to change the return type. For pre-handle is a first method execute in the interceptor, right? I am changing the return as a false. Let's see what's happening. Okay. Now I am sending request. So now I am getting only this statement. That meaning it execute only this method. This method is not executing post-handle and after completion. In some scenario, based on your logic, based on your code execution, you will return either true or false. If it is true, I want to execute this after completion and post completion, post handle. I want to execute post handle and after completion, after returning a true. Until returning a true, I don't want to execute this method. So in such a scenario, you can use this flag. Okay. I'll change to true now. So that is the purpose of this returning value. Then post handle. come to pre-handle only. Okay, I'll go to uncomment this line. You can see here request and the response object. You know already about these objects. Using the request object, you can do anything. Response object, I can set some data to the I can set some data. That data will be available in the client side. So I don't want to use this now. As part of filters, we have seen this. Now there is a third parameter, object and handler. Object handler. What is this handler? Whenever you send a request, that particular request associated with one controller class. That controller class we call it as a handler. I want to take that controller class meta information. Meta information nothing but what is the class name, what is the method executing, what is the signature of that method. I want to retrieve those information. In such a case, we can use third parameter. This is the main difference between filters and the interceptor. This operation not possible in filters. I am checking handler instance of handler method. This object may contain several handler class. There are several handler class at runtime. It may contain any handler instance. I want to check only if the instance is handler method instance. First I am checking handler not equal to null. My first condition is handler is not equal to null. Then handler object contain the instance of handler method. Then I am converting as a handler method class. Then after converting, from that handler method class, I am getting the method name. My expectation is method name must be the add customer. Okay. Then handler method dot get bin, get class, get name. This will return my class name. Then handler method dot get parameters. This is my handler method. In that method, I am passing one parameter. I can pass any parameter, any number of parameter, right? No restriction. So that this method return array of method parameter class. This method return array of method parameter class. As of now, my controller class having only one parameter, so that it will return array of method parameter class. This method parameter class contain only one object, method parameter object. I am iterating that. I am taking here parameter dot get parameter dot get name. This will return what is the parameter name. That meaning this will print this particular information. Okay. Through this we can get the meta information of your handler class. That is the purpose of interceptor. This is not possible in filter.
Suresh, Vijay.
Vijay, you tell me.
Yes, Suresh. Suresh, we are using handler instance here, right? So it will have all the data for your controller class. We are using handler instance.
Yes.
So if you have multiple controllers, how we can exactly know from which controller this will take?
No, at the time of requesting, it has the particular instance, right? That is come. You may have hundreds of controller, but
okay.
At the time of requesting one controller execute, at the moment that control instance available here.
Okay.
Consider this scenario. If we have a multiple methods within that single request, so is it possible to get all the method names within that interceptor?
Multiple request meaning what do you mean?
Multiple methods inside the single request. I can say it's a sub method of a parent method.
Whenever you are sending one request, right, through this method, this is the endpoint, right?
Yes.
As per interceptor, only this associated method get executed.
Okay.
Got it, right? For customer meaning, only execute this.
Got it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Now I'll see the demo for this.
Suresh, can you open once the configuration where we have configured this interceptor?
Yeah. Do you want to see that?
Yes. Once. Here, what is that line number 18, that parameter interceptor registry?
Well, that is the class coming from your Spring Boot API.
Spring Boot, okay.
Yeah, Spring Boot API. Spring this framework. Is my class. Yeah, this is a framework. Okay. Class. Using that framework class, you are adding that registry. Without this line, your interceptor will not work. Okay.
Can we have multiple interceptors?
We can have multiple interceptors. The reason I commented out is it will give multiple outputs. Will confuse while seeing the demo. That's the reason I commented out.
Okay.
These are
fine, sir. Yeah, thank you.
Started now. Got the response. See here, handle method name add customer, bean name, that's a class name, customer controller, method para name is a customer. So we're able to track this information. Okay. Then here post handle. The post handle, see here, we have a one more additional parameter, model view. Using this model view, we can access the customer object. We can access the customer object. Whatever entity object available, whatever request body we are passing here, that those things we can go into access through this model view object. The thing is, we need to pass the model view object. We have to pass here also. We have to pass here also part of the one argument. If you pass that, whatever data you are setting model object, we can access here also. Okay, that is another purpose of post, that we can do only post handle. We don't have a pre handle. Okay, then after completion of the request response, if you want to do some useful operation, the after completion means everything is completed. Now I want to do some activity. In such a case, we can do we can use for after completion. Okay, now I'll go to give one more scenario. Whenever send a request. That meaning you are calling an API, right? That meaning you are calling API. I want to find out how long that API taking to complete the request and response. I want to track this data. This is a very, very important data, right? For all the project, they should know. If you take more long, they have to optimize the application. Based on that time duration, we need to check the API. What is the problem with the API? We need to optimize that API. So I want to track this kind of record. I want to check each and every request, how long that particular API taking time. I want to find out. We'll go to see that particular example here. Here there is another interceptor I created. API monitor interceptor, implement handle interceptor. I implemented three methods. I implemented three override method, pre-handle, post handle and after completion. In the pre handle, see here, I am taking long start time system.current millis. Now I'll going to do something. I'm going to comment out this. I don't want to show this code now. Okay. Similarly, I want to okay. Now make it simple now. First I will explain this, okay. Whenever send a request, I am taking current time, that is a start time. Then I am setting this start time in the request attribute. I hope you are aware of the request attribute. Using request attribute, you can set a value. Whenever you set some value inside a request attribute, that value available until completion of the particular request. After completing a request, it won't be available. Okay, so I am setting request.set attribute. Start time is a key value. For this key value, I am setting this time, start time. So I'm setting the start timing of request. When this request started, that time I am setting, taking and setting into request object. Then whenever, after sending a response from the client, after generating a response, after completion will get invoked, right? In such a case, I am taking again current time. I am taking a current time release. Current time release. The current time release returns that particular current time. Okay. Then here, from the request object, here I set the here I set the start time. The pre-handler set the start time. Now I am taking that start time from the request object. Request.get attribute start time. I am taking start time and assigning to start time variable. Then long time duration, in time minus start time. Now this will return what is the time spent by this API. The total time available is the time duration. Here I am printing system.out.println handler. Handler nothing but return the particular customer controller class. This will print customer controller class ended processing and it took time. Took time is time duration millisecond. I am printing millisecond. This will return, this will print what is the handler method. In our case, customer control is handler method. That name will print. I am saying ended processing and it took time. Whatever time available here. That print in millisecond. So through this logic, we can find out how long particular API taking time to execute. Okay. Now we need to register this, right? I'll go to register. I'm uncommenting this. Now I'll go to comment this. Okay. Registry.add interceptor. I'm adding this API monitor interceptor. I'll go to start the application. Started. Handler method, handler class name and method name is printing, then ended processing, took time 8110 millisecond. To execute this API is taking 810 milliseconds. So through this way we can track them how long particular API taking time to complete the request. Okay. This is the purpose of interceptor.
Instead of having multiple custom, we can create one single interceptor and we can have the logic inside.
Yeah, that is based on your requirement. That is up to you.
Okay.
To modularizing, to make it a clean separation of the code, we can use multiple. Okay, if it is simple logic, you can go with the one interceptor. Okay, next one is, next topic we're going to talk about loggers. Various log levels. Okay. First, we'll going to check how to configure the loggers. What is the use of logger? Logger is a very, very important. What, see, let's say in the interceptor, right? API monitor interceptor, we are logging the information, logging the tracking time, how long particular API is taking time to log. Here I'm using system.out.println only. But in the real time, we should not use that. We have to use logs. Log.info, log.debug. Like that, we have to use a log. That log will store in particular log file. Okay, the using that log file, we can track our application, application performing. Through that log information, you can check, you can understand that your application behavior. If you have any issue, we have to go with log. By seeing the log only, we can find out the issue. The log is a more essential part in our project. Okay, Spring Boot supports a logback framework. There is one framework called logback. Logback library, using that library, we can implement the logging configuration because Spring Boot uses the logback library for logging framework. Okay, if you want to configure log, we have to use some configuration file called logback spring XML. Here we have to go with our configuration. I will tell one by there is a, you can see here one. Two section we have, two section and these two section, and apart from that there is a two, one more two section. There are four sections of configuration part. I will tell one by one. Here the line number 14, we are saying that property name lots value dot lots. That meaning I want my property name is a lots. I want to create a one folder under root for root folder. If you say dot slash logs, if it says dot slash logs, we can create a one folder under root path of a project. This is a root path. Interceptor iPhone log is a root path. In that root path, I want to create a one folder called logs. Okay, I want to see here. It's created. Actually, I am assigning this path inside log variable. This is a log, it's a variable name. Logs is a variable name. I'm assigning this path in the logs variable. This variable we can use in your configuration part. In your configuration, you can use it. Okay. I will tell that. One by one, we'll see that. So through this line, I am defining one path called dot slash logs. This dot slash logs assigned in the logs variable. Then here appender name equal to console. There are various type of appender. Here you can see appender type console under rolling type. What is console? If you say appender name equal to console, whatever log statement we are printing, that will be available in the server console. This is called a server console. This is called as a server console. I want to print all the logs here. So that is that configuration I am doing here. Appender name equal to console. This is a log file APIs we need to use. Okay, don't worry about this API. We have to follow this. We have to use this API. Then inside this pattern, inside this pattern tag, I am formatting my log statement, how my log statement should print. See, whenever print any SOP, what's happening here? Just this printing, this statement is printing, right? Whatever statement available here, that statement is printing. Here just is printing the statement, that's it. Okay, I want to come up with some format. I want to print in that format in my log files. Okay, that format we can define here using pattern tag. Inside the pattern, I am saying percentage d yyyy mmm ddd. Then time. So first, whenever print some log statement, I want to print a time. Then percentage thread. The log statement processed by particular thread. In Java, if you go to execute anything, that particular methods processed by one thread, right? It's like that, a log is processed by one thread. I want to print that thread process, thread name. Then this is percentage phi-hyphen level, meaning it's a print the level. What is the level of logging you are printing currently? That level will get print. Then percentage logger, meaning in which class that logger is coming from. In which class that logger is coming from, that class name will print. Finally, I am printing my message. Percentage message equal to percentage, meaning finally I am printing whatever message you want to print in the log. This is the format I have constructed to print the log inside a console. Okay. Now I'll go into the same controller class. I want to print some logs through this configuration. Okay, for that, in the controller class, we have to use one logger API called logger. This is in class level. Logger equal to log factory dot get logger. Then we have to pass the current class information. I am passing current class is the customer controller dot class. Get logger, we will do whatever logging I am printing. That log statement taken by getLogger and assigned to logger object. Through this logger object, I can print various log statement. In the line number 23, this is addCustomer method. I am saying logger info customer controller colon addCustomer start. I am printing this statement. I am printing only this statement. Along with this statement, whatever format I mentioned here, in this format it will print. Okay, then I'm going to print this also. Server started now. I'll go to invoke this API. I clean this. See here, this is the method, right? Customer add customer start. Customer add customer start. I printed only this method. Along with this this message, there is some additional information. This information coming from based on my configuration. This is the current date and time. This is the thread name that processed by logger. This is a log level. I am saying log.info here, right? I am saying here log.info. So it's printing log.info. Then what is the current class name? This is a controller.customerController printing. Finally, I am printing message. Finally, I am printing that message, that particular message is printing. After printing, I want to create a new lane, that is the app. Okay, so I configured a log statement to print in console. This is a console log. So here only we are configured, right? We are only configured, but we are not calling yet. We have to call, then only it will print, otherwise it will not print. Come back to line number 40. Line number 40, you are saying, there is one the root. Using root tag, we can tell. If you say root, it will print everything. Root meaning it will print everything. Whatever log produced by our Spring Boot application. Whatever log produced by our Spring Boot application, those logs I want to print. Info statement only I want to print. Those logs info I want to print. That is the meaning of this line. Here I am calling appender ref console. So I am calling this configuration. So the root level, whatever log statement coming from root level, I want to print those logs. Whatever configuration available inside a console appender. See, when you look at when you look at other Spring Boot application logs, those also print in the same format. Because of this format. Okay, root meaning I want to print all the logs, all the info logs in the consoler. In the console. The console nothing but is a configuration. This configuration I have defined here. Okay. So we need to call this configuration. Okay. Now second configuration is appender name equal to rolling file. Through this configuration, I want to generate a log. I want to store that log in a particular log file. Okay, it's not able to remove. I'll continue this. Okay, I removed. In the rolling file configuration, I am saying that create one file called app.log. That file must be available in under this logs folder. This logs variable pointing to ./logs, right? I want to create a one log file under this folder. This folder available inside a root path of your project. Okay. Then here I'm saying the same pattern with a different strategy. Buffered HD means it's a date only. I want to print date. I want to print a priority. Priority means what is a log level. Priority means what is the log level, info level, debug level, that level I want to print here. The second parameter I want to print that. It's a priority. Second parameter is a priority. Third is the current class name. Then buffered HD, nothing but a thread. What is the thread processed by that log? then message. I want to print in this pattern. I want to print in this pattern in my log file. In my log file. Okay, this format will print in our app.log file. Whenever start the application, based on this configuration, app.log get generated under root folder, that is log folder. Then this is the configuration I mentioned. Through this configuration, I mentioned what is the file name, that where that file should generate it. Then what is the format I want to print inside a log. Then rolling policy. Using rolling policy, I can backup the log files. I don't want to dump all the data inside a log files. Okay. In certain time of period, for example, if the file reaches particular size, I don't want to add more logs in that file. I want to create that backup. Then I want to generate one more log file. In that new log file, I want to store my log statement. I want to do that such a configuration. For that, we can use rolling policy. Here, file name pattern. In the logs root folder, under that folder, create one more folder called archive. Then my log file start with app hyphen. Now log file start with app hyphen. Then %d. I want to create that file like app hyphen current date dot backup number. Let's say if you are getting a very first time this configuration, then once start the application, the log will get generated in your file, app.log file. Once this app.log file reaches 5 MB, here I mentioned 5 MB, the max file size is a 5 MB. If the app.log reaches 5 MB, at that time, take that app.log, copy that app.log, rename it to in this format. If it is a very first time, I substitute as a zero. app-date.0.log, like this it will create. That is, it will create like this. app-date is a date, right? Date meaning it's a 2021-02-21.0.log, like this will create backup file. After creating this backup file, it will create a new file inside the logs folder. In that new file, start producing the logs. Okay, this is the configuration of rolling policy. Okay, now I have done this configuration. Now I want to call this configuration. I am calling this configuration here. Using root. I am printing the console configuration. If you say root, everything will print. Wherever log is generating from your application, those info logs print in console. But here I am saying logger name equal to com.itgarden. What I am saying is, whatever logs generated under itgarden, let's say in itgarden I have a customer class, some interceptors, some classes available, only some few classes available. If this classes uses log statement, that log will print in rolling file. Also I want to print console. That particular logs, whatever classes available inside itgarden package, those files, if generated the log file, generated the log statement, that log statement I want to print in my file. As well as console. Okay, now I'm going to comment this. I don't want to call console now. Okay. Append the ref equal to, I'm calling rolling file. Based on this configuration, if any classes I used under itgarden, if that class uses the logger, that log information stored in that particular file, app.log file. Okay. Now I'll go to customer controller. The customer controller, I'm using logger.info customer controller colon add customer star. My expectation is this particular log statement print in app.log file, which I configured here. Okay. Now I'll go to start my application. Here nothing, here it's a blank, right? I'll go to start the application. Well, server is started now. When you look at the location, there is an app log generator, 0 bytes. I'm opening it. Okay, now it's become 1 byte. Some logs printed here, no, application logs. Okay. Then, I'll go to invoke this API. Invoked. See here, I'm able to see this log information. Info log, I'm able to see here, right? Okay. Here, one more parameter we have added, right? Level equal to info. I want to print only info statement. Additivity equal to false. What is the meaning of additivity equal to false? For example, I'm calling this console here also. What it means? Whatever log. For example, I am printing customer control, customer controller, add customer start. I am printing these two statements, right? So these two statements, I am saying that print the statement console as well as rolling file. See here, as of now, it's not printing. Whatever API executed, right? That print statement not available here because I commented out previously. Okay. Now I'm going to calling the console configuration as well as rolling file configuration. Now I'm going to restart the application. Let's see what's happening. I'm calling again. See, now it's printing console also because I enabled it. It's a console also, it's a printing. Also, it print in here also. Okay. Now, I'll going to remove this parameter. Clear the log. I am sending a request. See here, it's printing two times. To avoid this problem, why is printing two times? I'm calling this root level also. I'm calling this in the logger level also, in the IT garden level also. I want to print a console log here as well as here. So it's printing two times. To avoid this duplication, we have to use this particular parameter. Additivity equal to false. By default, this parameter value is true. It will print duplicates. To avoid these duplicates, we are using this particular parameter. Okay. Now I'll go to restart the application. Now it started. Again sending. Now it's printing only one time. Because of this property, I change it to additivity equal to false. Okay. This is the basic of logging configuration in our application. Then apart from that, you should know what is the info, what is a debug, what is a error. Based on your scenario, you need to put the particular level of statement. Here I want to print info. Info means it's just information. I'm saying that add customer method is executing. Add customer method is ending like this. I'm saying here, if you're going to catching some exception, I'm going to catching some exception, I'm throwing some exception. In that exception block, you can say logger dot error, that you can say. Okay, like that, you can, there is a various levels of log statement we can do in our application. Let's show one diagram, one tabular column. See here, these are the various log levels, right? As of now, we have seen info levels. Yeah, if you say log.trace, what will happen? Info, debug also print, info also print, warn also print, error also print, fatal also print. One more thing I want to tell, fatal is not supported by logback. Fatal level is not supported by logback, so it won't work. Let's see, I'll go to change into debug. I'll give you the one example, then you can understand that particular tabular column. Not here, sir. Info. Let it be info here. I'll change it to your debug. Sorry. So once I say debug, see, you can see a lot of debug statement here. You see that, right? You can see the difference. I change it to debug. You can see a lot of debug statement. See here. Also, you can see here, apart from the debug statement, you can see info. I put level equal debug, but it's printing debug as well as info. I'll change again info. Now you can see only info statement, right? Okay. So only few lines is printing in the console. At the moment I am changing debug, it print lot. Okay. We spent a lot of debug statement as well as info statement also. Now I'm going to send the request. I sent a request. See, my info statement also printed. Apart from, there are system level debug statement printed. So meaning of if you say debug, it's eligible to print info also. Debug, if you say debug, it's print info also. That is a meaning. That is a tabular column I have given here. If your log level is a debug, it won't print trace. It won't print trace, but it will print a debug, info, warn, error. Everything will print. That is the meaning of this tabular column. If you place log level trace, everything will print. Everything will print. Expect fatal. Fatal won't support in logback. Okay. If you put info, trace will not print. Debug will not print. Info, warn, error, fatal, error will print. If you put warn, trace will not print. Debug will not print. Info will not print. Warn and error will print. If you put error level, it will print only error. Okay, if you print a fatal won't support. If you say there is a level called all, if you say all, everything will print. Everything will print. If you say off, nothing will print. Okay, these are the various levels of logs. You can understand this tabular column right now. Okay, now I'll go to say all. See, there are many logs will come. If you say trace, log, everything. So trace, you can say trace also here. Everything will come. If you say all, it will keep on go. this is not error. Okay, skip on, go. Okay, I don't want to stop that. Then I want to say off. This is mandatory, right? That's it. Nothing is printing. Only three lines of printing, nothing is printing. That is called as off. Okay. So this is the logback configuration. And if you have any question, you can ask.
So this in your app, log file, right? So it always happen your info every time you run, rerun the server.
Yes, yes. Up and every time up and if it reaches that size, it will get a new archive. It will get a new file.
Okay.
Okay, tomorrow I'm going to say hat use. Okay, hat use and if possible, IOP. Still not subscribe this channel. Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.